The Rude Awakening.
Wacky, 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 whacking. At 7:10. Whackers will know all the world. Wacky, 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 whacking.
Morning,
now,
sir.
I heard you yesterday, and I don't want to play that today. I don't want to let you play that today.
Not?
No, because it's a follow-up.
Okay.
It's a follow-up to a legendary interview.
Which I initially got into a lot of trouble for, yes. But then people saw the funny side.
Exactly. Now, I walked into the studio yesterday when you were interviewing. Well, I'll use the word interviewing rather loosely.
Correct, yes.
James Blunt.
Yes. Now he's just released his new album called All the Lost Souls.
Yes.
All right. It's a worldwide release date.
And they had one interview available for South Africa, and they came to us and said, would we do the interview? And we said, yes, of course. Darren will do it.
And they were a bit.
Which they should have been. And
yeah.
Having heard the interview going down, part of it yesterday, they had every right to be. But we will play that for you tomorrow.
The James Blunt interview.
The James Blunt interview. We'll play that tomorrow because I want to go back in time to an interview you did. And this is in the same vein as the James Blunt one tomorrow.
Yeah, this was where it all started.
This is where the persona was born.
Whackhead in the morning.
Whackhead in the morning.
Presenter of the biggest breakfast show in South Africa.
This is on the CD.
This is on
Serial
the CD.
Serial Prankster.
Correct.
Which is on sale now.
Everywhere.
But the James Blunt one is coming up. Do you remember the Ali Campbell interview?
Hello.
Hi, is that Ali Campbell?
It is. Is that Darren?
Oh, yes, it is, Ali. Let me just explain quickly. We're going to be starting the interview in a minute, and we're going to start it with the jingle that opens my radio show, and then we're going to get straight into it after that, because we're going to be recording it live to tape.
Okay.
Okay, stand by. Whackhead in the morning, weekdays 6 to 9, and a goodly, goodly, goodly morning to you all over Johannesburg, the city that never sleeps. And oh yes, remember, this show proudly brought you by Kotex Pony Liners. Wear them so you can play tennis, go river rafting, and do all the normal day-to-day stuff, ladies. Okay, now that we've paid my salary, this morning it's a privilege we're speaking to Ali Campbell, lead singer of the band U2, UB40.
Yo, what's up, Darren?
Welcome to Whackhead in the Morning.
Well, it's good to be here. Or good to be talking to you anyway.
Yes, now, first time in South Africa, Alan. Are you looking forward to it?
Did you say, is it our first time in South Africa?
Yes, are you looking forward to it?
No, we've been to South Africa about six times.
What, like on holiday or stuff?
No, we've played plenty of shows there. We love South Africa. In fact, we hold the attendance record in Johannesburg for when we came and played after Mandela was released, which still stands at 80,000 people.
Well, Ali, I think you should check your facts, mate, because the current record for concert attendance is 87,000 by Michael Bolton. Okay, now, I just want to tell you, if there is a rat in your kitchen, what are you going to do?
Oh, well, I'd shoot that rat. That's what I'd do.
So, being a reggae band, Alan, I take it you all grew up in Jamaica.
No, we grew up in the south part of Birmingham called Borsal Heath, which was predominantly a West Indian sort of area. West Indian and Indian.
Sorry, I must have got the wrong brief. I think I got the brief for Shaggy. Yes, I did. Oh, right. Okay. You in your band, you've got your sister Robin, right?
Yeah, my sister Robin plays guitar and sings with me.
Hey, can you just close the studio door, please? We're busy in the middle of an interview here with Alan Campbell. Sorry, Alan, we'll pick it up from there. Right. All right, okay, so UB40 and IP29. I wrote that one this whole weekend, Alan.
Yeah, that's good.
So, I don't know what else to say. What else can you tell me, Ali?
Well, UB40 are again making another brilliant album, which will be out at the end of the year.
Okay, is there anything else you want to talk about, Alan?
And of course, we're coming over to play in South Africa with the Live Earth crew.
How's the weather?
Well, it's really sunny.
I just wanted to find out. So, hold on, where are we? Where are we? Okay, great. I've run out of stuff to ask.
Oh, well, should we talk about our new album and my new solo album?
No, not really.
No,
we're going to talk about UB40 being in town, right?
Well, the last time we were in South Africa was in 2002.
All right, so, Alan, that's all we have time for. We're looking really forward to seeing you in the home of the Big Five. This is Whackhead in the Morning, and now airing for the very first time in South Africa, it's the brand new single from UB40. Would you like to introduce it, Ali?
Yeah, this is Who You're Fighting For by UB40.
No, I don't think we've been sent that one yet.
Oh, which one you got then?
This one? All right, okay, I'm going to play that for the first time in South Africa on air. I'm going to play it again for you, and you can just introduce it, all right?
Okay.
Okay, we'll just pick it up. Okay, Alan, that's all we have time for.
Okay, well, here's our brand new single called Red, Red Wine.
It's fantastic. Oh, hearing it for the first time here on 94.7 Highfield Stereo, it's Whackhead in the Morning, babies.